Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, why you have an extra click when you're advancing slides in some presentations in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if this has ever been something that you encountered where you're just going along and some songs you hit the space bar, right arrow key, etc., and it displays immediately. Others you have to click it twice for every slide, not just the first one. Go ahead, like, subscribe, click the bell icon. Tell me about it in the comments below. This is something that can bite you if you're not looking for it. And it can also bite you if you don't know what could be causing it. So let's head over to my computer and we'll talk about one of the causes here. So here we are in Pro 7, and what I'm talking about is, let's say that you're just going through here. It should be that as soon as you click on a slide, it shows up, whether you're on a dissolve or a cut or one of the transitions you probably should never use, personal opinion. Notice that it just comes up immediately. Now, if it always takes another click, I want to show you what you should look for. So the first thing that I would do is, well, let me show you how you could have accidentally got it. So if you've got this selected and you go here into build and you have a build on it, and it's set to on click right here. So if we go back here to show, notice there's a little circle underneath there. So for this one, oh, it's not showing up. I have to click it again. You see that? And notice this little green circle down here. And when you immediately click on it, notice the empty circle there. That is what I'm talking about. Basically, you can add a build into a slide and have it do that. Now, you might be thinking, well, I didn't do that. Well, let me show you what might have happened. If we right click and go to themes, and I'm going to create a new theme from selection, and let's just call this double click. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Although you wouldn't make nearly as obvious a mistake there. Now, let me just click on anyone, and I'm going to right-click, go down to themes, and select the double-click theme that we just created, and actually, let me select all and do that. Themes, double click, there we go. And notice It adds that circle to all of them. So a build can be saved with a theme. So if you didn't know that it was like that, then as soon as you get on this, notice, have to click it twice. 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 And all of those are like that. Now, to solve that, you can apply a different theme here. So let's right click, go to themes, and let's just select this all caps CMG sans 80. That did fix it, so I'm going to select all and do the exact same thing. Themes, CMG sans 80, all caps. And now it removes all that, and we're back to where we were, where it's just a single click to advance to the next slide. So, anytime you run into that problem, that's the very first thing that I would check. If it's just being slow, that's a totally different thing, and we'll talk about that on another tutorial. First thing I would do is check how much media and if it's the right resolution. But I digress. So those are the things I would check if I had to double click on a slide to make it show up in Pro 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro, the number 7 and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchCheckU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.